all of you to please put your mobiles in the silent mode. Thank you. So please come on the stage and be seated.
Blessings of the gracious Almighty, I now request everyone present to rise for the Saraswati Vandana.
To present bouquets to Professor and Mrs. J.B. Joshi and to Professor D.N. Saraf.
Yes, please.
Thank you, Tanya, Shantani and Purvakshi. On behalf of UPES Dehradun and the Indian Institute of Chemical Engineers UPES Student Chapter, I, Nikita Goyal, take this opportunity to welcome all the dignitaries on the dais, esteemed teachers and my colleagues to this distinguished lecture to be delivered by a very eminent chemical engineer, Padma Bhushan Professor J.B. Joshi. I also welcome Mrs. Joshi, who is here to grace this auspicious occasion. Professor Joshi has very kindly accepted our invitation. We are truly honored by your presence, sir and ma'am. I now invite Dr. Santosh K. Gupta to tell us about this lecture.
Professor D.N. Saraf, colleagues and my dear students, now that this lecture series has taken some kind of a shape, it's time for us to review what all has happened. Okay. And we've had absolutely great people giving this lecture. Of course, the student body keeps changing, the faculty remain the same almost, okay? So they will know, okay? The first person, the inaugural lecture was delivered by, in 2012-13, by none other than Padma Vibhushan, Professor M.M. Sharma, Fellow of the Royal Society, FRS, all right, at the ICT, it used to be UTCT that time, now ICT, Institute of Chemical Technology in Mumbai. As I said, he's a fellow of the Royal Society, FRS. He's a fellow of the what was called earlier as the Third World Academy of Science. For those of you who will not know this, all right, I might mention that this academy in Trieste, Italy, was founded by a Nobel Prize winner in physics, Professor Abdus Salam. Okay, now of course Third World has a dirty meaning, so it's called as the World Academy of Science, but the symbol is the same, FTWAS. He is also the fellow of the National Academy of Indian National Academy of Science, FNA, fellow of FASC of the Indian Academy of Sciences at Bangalore, founded by Sir C. V. Raman, a fellow of the National Academy of Sciences, NASI, at Allahabad, founded by Meghnath Saha, and also fellow of the Indian National Academy of Engineering, all of these things. I won't be explaining all these things again, because almost all of us here, and that's his photograph. The second lecture next year, 2013-14, was delivered by Professor M.S. Anand, who was two-time director of IIT Madras, and then, of course, he spent some time at IIT Bangalore, from where he came. Of course, later on, he also moved to IIT Bombay. Now he's back as a distinguished professor at IIT Madras. Okay, In fact, he's a fellow of the Indian National Academy of Engineering, FNAE. Okay, I'd actually invited him to come and join me in improving our department still further. He declined. I wish he had agreed to that. Anyway, the third lecture was Professor K.S. Gandhi from IIT Bangalore, okay, fellow of the Raman Academy, C.V. Raman Academy and FNAE, right, that's his photograph. Gandhi was a faculty member at IIT Kanpur, right, and formed part of the triumvirate of polymer engineering at IIT Kanpur, me, Anil Kumar and Gandhi. Okay, of course, in mid-80s, he moved to Bangalore and Professor Kumar had too much effect on him and he stayed on. If you feel that too many people from ICTS are coming over here to deliver lectures, all right, you're not wrong. The fourth lecture was by a colleague of Professor Sharma and Professor Joshi, right? Professor Pandit from ICT Mumbai, is FNA, FASC, FNASC, FNAE, right? That's his photograph, all right? The fifth lecture last year was from a non-academic person, all right? Uday Agarwal, he was a faculty member at IIT Delhi once upon a time, okay? But then he went abroad, Andover, all right? Then came back and joined Reliance Industries, okay? And now he's heading the R&D center of Grasim or Adit Birla Research Center, okay? So that was a change of pace for us. And then, of course, we have the sixth lecture today by Padma Bhushan Professor J.B. Joshi, who's also a fellow of the World Academy of Sciences, FNA, FASC, FNAE. Okay? And I think that's all for me. All right, I hand over charge again to Nikita. Thank you.
I now invite our head of the department, Professor D.P. Vijay, to formally introduce our distinguished speaker. So.
Nikita, good morning to all. So before I start introducing Professor Joshi, I just want to tell what I feel when I was preparing this introduction. We gather information from internets and some various sources, and I made an introduction for nearly 1.5 pages. So recently we got the short resume from Joshi sir. When I saw that, it was only 3 pages. So the difference was, we used to put, as faculty, most of our faculty, we used to put, we have published in these papers, we will have the list of publications. But when I saw his short resume, he has given the list of awards. So I start formally introduce Padma Bhushan Professor Joshi. And this is my honor, privilege, whatever you can add, to introduce our distinguished speaker today. And now he is currently the Emeritus Professor in Homi Bhabha National Institute, Mumbai, Honorary Distinguished Professor, ICT, Mumbai, Adjunct Professor, Department of Chemical Engineering, Curtin University, Australia, Adjunct Professor, Department of Chemical Engineering, Louisiana State University, Los Angeles. So 4 positions right now. And Coming to his academic history, I can say he has completed his bachelor's chemical engineering and master's in chemical engineering from UDCT, and now it is ICT Mumbai from in 1971 and 72. And he has started his research under the guidance of the eminent chemical engineer, which Professor S.K. Gupta started with the inaugural lecture of this distinguished series, Professor M.M. Sharma. And he has completed his PhD in 1977 and started his career as professor in ICT Mumbai in 1972. His research areas are fluid mechanics, CFD, design of multiphase reactors, renewable energy resources such as solar, atomic energy and bioenergy. So he has guided 86 PhD students, 60 masters and 25 postdoctoral fellows. So, coming to his research publications, I am not going to read, I am just giving you the numbers. Number of international publications, 509. Number of conference presentations, 110. And number of papers in conference proceedings is 30. And citations is how many people have referred your papers, 16,200. His H index is 62. So, as Professor Gupta has already announced, what is FTWAS, FNAE, FNASE, and in the slide it is clearly mentioned FTWAS, FNA, FNASE, and FNAE. I don't want to explain it again. He has been the editorial and advisory, he is in the editorial board and advisory board of several high impact journals like Chemical Engineering Science, Chemical Engineering Research and Design, Reviews in Chemical Engineering, Canadian Journal of Chemical Engineering, and it's going on. So I'm going to take another sheet. This is to read out what all the awards we have. So this is only a selective, and the list is 1.5 pages. I don't want to take his time from his lecture. So it starts from 1981. So Science Academy Medal for Young Scientist in 1981, Amar Dai Chem Award in 1983, and Hedilia Award of Excellence in Basic Research from Indian Institute of Chemical Engineers in 1989, and Fellow of Indian Academy of Science, that is in 1991, and Bhatnagar Award in 1991, Best Teacher Award of Chemical Engineering, Department of Chemical Technology from ICT Mumbai in 1992, and selected as Diamond during the Diamond Jubilee function of the Department of Chemical Technology, ICT Mumbai in 1994, and Fellow of the Indian National Science of Academy, 1995, Goyal Foundation Award of Engineering Sciences from Kurukshetra in 1998, Vishwakarma Medal of Indian National Science of Academy in 2000, Maharashtra State Best Teacher Award in 2004, Dr. Ranji Reddy Innovator of the Year Award in 2005, and Diamond for Outstanding Contribution to Education, Research and Industry from ISCHE KIMCON in 2007. Chemical Society, ACS, selected him among the top 100 research scientists over a period of 40 years of existence of industrial engineering chemistry research on the basis of high impact publication in 2007. J.C. Bose Fellow of the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India in 2008. Lifetime Achievement Award, Indian Chemical Council, the APEX Professional Organization of Indian Chemical Manufacturers in 2008. 2008, Fellow of the World Academy of Sciences. This is in Italy, 2008. Platinum Jubilee Award ICT 2009, and it's not final, Padma Bhushan in 2014, and tomorrow he is getting another award for this year, that is Eminent Engineer given by Engineer Council of India, that is tomorrow, 4th of April 2018, and this award is given only for two people every year, one from academic and one from industry. And in this, Nandan Nilekani is getting award along with him. That is tomorrow. And with this, he helped in setting up a large number of commercial reactors in India and abroad, developed new and novel process design products and implemented in large, medium and small scale industries, and designed more than 1,000 multi-phase reactors, extensively participated in process intensification. He has developed new designs for household cookers and stoves with thermal efficiency of 50 to 60%, which is having a thermal efficiency before of 12 to 20%. And I am going to quote few lines from your mentor, sir, M.M. Sharma's. On his retirement from ICT Mumbai in 2009, Professor M.M. Sharma has given some comments on his. I am just reading, it's verbatim, there is no change. This has appeared in Industrial Engineering Chemical Research, published in 2009. So the verbatim is this: he is a unique person who has combined humility with the desire to help person even out of turn, and yet possesses the firmness to handle difficult tasks. He is leaving behind a rich culture and wish him great success in his prestigious assignment with Department of Atomic Energy. This is verbatim from the paper. So with this, what more we can mere mortals add? Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. So without any further ado, I now invite Padma Bhushan Professor J.B. Joshi to deliver the 6th annual UPES Distinguished Lecture in Chemical Engineering.
Other faculty members and dear students. Are you able to hear me backside? Not yet. Yes? Okay. Together on two technologies in petroleum industry which have been implemented already. We introduced novel reactors for brisk breaking, which are implemented in more than 4 locations in Indian Oil Corporation. Professor Santosh has been my close friend, and wherever he is, he definitely calls me for the lecture. Kanpur he was for several years, I gave lecture there. In Mumbai, IIT Mumbai, he was for few years, but then also he called me there for lecture. And you know, the perfectionist, more than, in my opinion, more than Amir Khan, is more perfectionist. I'm going to give lecture how we engineers can participate in enhancing the wealth of our nation. That is the overall summary of the lecture. When any university starts. And I'm going to quote what are the vision statements of variety of institutions and universities. I will not read completely. ICT Mumbai, that is my university, and I was the first vice chancellor. So it is the vision statement under my supervision. We shall be creators of sprouting knowledge and design cutting-edge technologies that will have the greatest impact on society and benefit mankind at large. UPES Dehradun, to be an institution of global standing for developing professionally competent talent, contributing to nation building. So what I want to emphasize with those red words, everywhere we mean that the knowledge so generated will be useful to the society and nation building. If we take MIT USA, next slide. IIT Mumbai, say for example, see the red part of it, and generates new knowledge for society and industry. That is the principle. MIT USA, the institute is committed to generating, disseminating, and preserving knowledge, and to working with others to bring this knowledge to bear on the world's greatest challenges. So we need to be so useful for the nation. And to be useful for our nation, what is the most important problem that our nation faces? And that problem is our nation is poor. The per capita income, as you know, is about 1 lakh rupees per year per person. And that is the most important problem. So let us see. In summary, what is that university should be doing is generation of new knowledge and dissemination to the society for solving the problem. And most important problem of our nation, I mentioned to you already. There has been a nice survey throughout the world, and it says that 50%, more than 50% of innovations, they happen in university system and not in industry. Many of them, they happen in national laboratories and very few in industry. So if you see whatever innovations have happened in the recent past, you know, of course, the Facebook and the mobile and the new electronic gadgets. And all these innovations are converted into wealth by those nations. And all those innovations basically occur in the university system. So therefore, what is required? A balanced approach between fundamental sciences and engineering science, the innovations, and implementation of those innovations. This is the summary of all the vision statements that I have said earlier. I can cite many more. You can read all the vision statements. Everywhere it says that we will create knowledge for the benefit of society, right? And it has to happen through innovations. Next slide. So I said that this is available on the net, right? And the innovative ability of those nations is also ranked on the web page, right? And the information so given in the web, I have plotted it. That is the innovation ranking and the GDP per capita income of that country. And there is fairly good parity line. So in 152 nations, we are 140th from the top in terms of per capita income, or 12th from the bottom, 12th from the bottom. So we nicely say that we are a developing country, but we are basically a poor country, 12th from the bottom. And if you see our innovative index, which is also similar in the world, and therefore we get a parity plot, to be more specific, it is 82. So we rank 82nd in terms of new innovations that we have been doing. Next slide.